The Ah-Tah-Thi-Ki Museum is on the Big Cypress Seminole Indian Reservation in southern Florida. It's a great place to learn about the Seminole people, their history, and culture. There are over 30,000 unique artifacts on display there. Miss Joy, the museum educator, was waiting to give us a tour.
Chehun Tamo, that means hello and welcome. And to the Ah-Tah-Thi-Ki Museum, the Museum of the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Would you like to go inside?
Sure.
The Seminole were not originally a single tribe, but an alliance of different tribes that migrated to Southwest Florida from parts of Georgia, Alabama, and Mississippi in the early 1800s. They traditionally lived by hunting and fishing, and much of their everyday life was spent gathering and preparing food.
Only women cooked, and as you can see, it represents three generations. So she's sitting down because she is the elder. This is the mother, so she'd be the second generation, and she's doing most of the work.
This young girl is about my age. No school for her. She's learning how to prepare the dishes she will have to cook for her family when she's older.
Are these the canoes they would go out in the Everglades with?
It is. And as you can see, this is a very long canoe. There are a lot of things in this canoe. The whole family is in this one. And it's because they're probably going to a trading post. And they would be gone for sometimes a week or two, so the whole family would go.
Time to go outside and explore some more.
Was the swamp important to the Seminole people?
The swamp is very important to the Seminole people. Lots of food and vegetation is found in the swamp. Different animals that they eat are found out here, things like alligators.
How did they manage to live out here in the heat and all?
Well, Seminoles live in something that's called a chiqui. It's a little open air kind of hut type, and it has a thatch roof made from the palm fronds, and they do a lot under there, and that keeps them cool throughout the day.
What about all the mosquitoes?
Well, the mosquitoes do bother them, but they have the heat from that fire, and the smoke actually detracts mosquitoes.
In the center of the Cypress Swamp is an example of a living village. Each chiqui hut has a specific purpose. This one's the cooking chiqui. It really does stay cool in there. Some of the Seminole artisans work at their crafts here. I love these beautiful bead necklaces being made by Miss Sally.
This is a very elaborate skill. It takes a lot of work and a lot of technical ability. Some of the beads, like those right here, are in traditional colors, things that are important to the Seminoles. For example, this is a medicine color.
Amazing how resourceful the Seminole people are. They learned to live in what must have been and still is a challenging environment. No mosquito control in those days, and definitely no air conditioning.